Vintage Festivali'nde saatler ilerledikçe havada kararmaya başladıkça kalabalık da artıyor. Şu anda sahnede son zamanların en önemli metal gruplarından Trivium var ve heyecanla Trivium izliyoruz. Bugün en önemli gruplarından metalin son zamanlardaki en başarılı isimlerinden Trivium'la birlikteyiz. Hello guys, welcome to Turkey. How are you feeling? How was your day? You were here last night, right? You
yeah, came last night. We got in last night, and we've just kind of been hanging out, taking in the sights, enjoying the view from the hotel, and eating a lot of kebabs.
As I heard, Matt went outside, but he stayed hotel, right?
No, we went out.
Oh, you went out.
We went out,
out
around the, like, that area. So Matt has, I think, some friends that are they're living here, so they took him wherever he went off to.
Okay, so congratulations on your Golden Gods Award.
Thank you.
You won the Video of the Year Award. How does it feel? How does it feel to be a winner now?
We feel special.
Yeah, we wanted to do something different with our music videos from what we did in the past, so we had a pretty ambitious idea as far as the, I guess, artistic, I guess, side of things for our music video. And it came out great, so it's cool that the fans and everyone recognized the video as being a killer video, because that's what we're trying to set out to do, is do something different for a metal video and represent our music in a different way than just, like, the what we've done in the past. So it's, it was awesome to win an award for it.
Yeah, exactly. Europe tour and North America tour, if I'm not wrong. So I think you guys get along well, huh?
Yeah, I mean, not only do we get along well, but I mean, if you kind of go back in In Flames' back catalog, you'll kind of find where that they really influenced our sound. You know, some of the first In Flames records are definitely influential, not only on us as a band, but, you know, all the American metal bands that have come out in the last 5 or 10 years. And they're great dudes. They like to drink, they like to eat food. We like to do the same, and we just mesh very well. And when you find a band that you get along with, it's nice to tour with them when you can.
So you guys have a kind of a new member in the band right now.
Yes.
How's everything with Nick, and how's the feedback for Inmates?
It's been great. Ever since Nick came into the band, he meshed really well, and we didn't miss a beat. We actually gained a couple. He's a great drummer, really fits in well with our style. He can play all of our material from the back catalog, like, just like the album, or even better. And then also the new album kind of speaks for itself as far as what he brings to the band. And it definitely was a much needed, you know, change that we needed as a band to move forward. And ever since this, you know, In Waves came out, things have just really gotten to another level, you know, all over the world. Europe's been just amazing for us now. It's really kind of picked up. And then also this record, the buzz it's created and just everything about it. You know, we've been getting offers to play. You know, we finally made it to Turkey the first time. We're going to Bulgaria for the first time, South America. So it's definitely given us a lot of opportunities to go to places we haven't been before. And even the places we have been, the shows we've been playing at, you just see the reactions just, you know, at another level than it was a couple years ago. So everything's been going really good for us.
Wow, it sounds great. So how does it feel to be sharing the stage with Megadeth?
Awesome. Always a pleasure.
You know, we've played, you know, just in the last, what, like, year or so, we did Mayhem in the U.S. with them all summer, and then we've done a couple festivals here and there, so it's cool that it's just for, I guess, bands outside of Turkey, us being the two bands that get to play together is pretty awesome. So, you know, we definitely
Who was your metal god when you were teenagers?
They were definitely one of them, you know, I mean, Megadeth, Slayer.
Megadeth or Metallica? For me,
it's Metallica. Okay. I know for Corey, it's Megadeth.
Well, I think it's unfair to, like, pit them against
totally
each other because they're
totally different
bands, and they bring so much to the metal spectrum as far as influence and style. You know, there's definitely similarities between the two, but also, you know, both bands have their very unique thing. It's kind of like, you know, like, hey, Metallica or Slayer. It's like it's two different animals.
Yeah.
So it's just the fact that there's a connection between members that everyone tries to pit it against each
other. Without, I think, Megadeth, I don't think there would be such a genre as, like, technical metal.
Yeah.
But, like, you know, Rust in Peace, I think, is probably, I mean, that's got to be
That's the pinnacle of
Yeah, that's the pinnacle thrash. Of, like, technical thrash. It's not even really a thrash record. It's just like its own thing, and I mean that record alone.
It is what it is.
Yeah, it totally. When you can't really pin a record to a genre, yeah. I think that's when it's special. And that record for all of us, you know, you can put it on. It's timeless. It's got its own thing, and I, you know, we got to see them when they did the whole Rust in Peace, uh-huh. you know, front to back, and it was that was a pretty special.
You gotta be
special
record.
You know, we could bust out Metallica covers and Slayer covers. Not that those songs aren't hard, but it's like when it comes to Megadeth, like especially the solos, it's like another world. You know, and
you gotta be
pretty much Chris Broderick to cover the whole spectrum of all the guitar players that have been in the band. We'll be right back.